Welcome to another episode of Ask the Expert on Fox 4. I'm your host, Hannah Guthrie, and today my expert on buying a house, getting a mortgage, which I know can be very challenging, is Myra McFarland with Wyndham Capital Mortgage. Thanks for being with us, Myra.
Thanks, Hannah.
Okay, it seems like the entire world knows about the seller's market and how prices are rising and there's bidding wars for houses. And I think some people are thinking, oh my gosh, is this going to be another crash like we had in 2008? Do you think we're in another bubble?
I really don't, Tana. And I get asked a lot about, are we going to have another bubble just like 2008? And really, the market today couldn't be more different compared to 2008. The National Association of Realtors tells us that there are actually 25% more households in the U.S. today, and there's actually only 25% of the number of homes for sale compared to 2008. So it's really just a supply and demand issue that we have.
So more of a housing shortage.
Absolutely. We have a lot of buyers entering the market and not enough houses to sell.
And I think in 08, I mean, I think there are probably pretty lax mortgage standards, you know, where anybody who wanted a loan could just say, hey, I make this amount, don't bother checking it, and they got the loan. But now it's a little different, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Ever since the bubble burst in 2008, the requirements to get a mortgage have been much more strict. We actually do verify your income. We don't have stated income, no doc loans that we did back then. Which is a good thing. We also don't have subprime loans anymore. And so that's really, only qualified buyers are actually getting into homes.
All right, let's talk about your qualified buyer. Okay, so they're looking for a house and they're in bidding war after bidding war. What can they do to position themselves to be the buyer that the seller chooses?
So the number one thing that I tell everyone is to make sure that you get pre-approved and not just pre-qualified. So here at Wyndham, we have a true pre-approval process where we don't just take your application and pull your credit. We actually have you provide your documents, things like your pay stubs, your tax returns, your bank statements, and we'll submit them to an underwriter for actual review. That way we have been able to overcome any hurdles that may come up down the road. And it really makes the process go a lot smoother. And in some cases, we can close a lot faster if you've went through our pre-approval process first.
Yeah, that would make sense because you've done all the hard work up front. Because it is hard collecting all those documents, finding your tax return,
yes.
Getting all of that.
Cumbersome tasks, yes. The paperwork, the hard paperwork process, yes.
So what's probably the most common question a buyer asks when they walk into your office or they call you on their own line? What are they asking you when they're applying for a loan?
The most common question I get asked is, how much do I need for a down payment? And check with your lender because every lender is different. We have programs that are that require only 3% down. So you might be surprised that you can get into a home for less money than you thought.
What if you're a veteran?
And also, if you're a qualified veteran, you can actually purchase with a zero down payment. It's a great program.
So you've got a lot of options. That's nice.
Yes.
So what about the person who is thinking about buying, but they can't afford to right now? They've got their own house. They've got an existing mortgage. Does it make sense for them to refinance right now?
Yes, it might. Not everyone can benefit from refinancing, but in a lot of cases today, check your interest rate, talk to your loan officer. You might be surprised that rates are still super low this year in 2021. And depending on how long you plan to stay in the home, there may be an opportunity for a lot of savings. Another way that you can save with a refinance is if you're paying PMI, also called private mortgage insurance. So if you purchased your home and didn't put 20% down, more than likely you're paying PMI. And a lot of my clients have been able to save in that aspect as well. So we might be lowering their interest rate, but we might also be able to drop the PMI if their home value has went up so much that they now have over 20% equity. And in some cases, if we can't drop the PMI, we can still substantially reduce it, which is another way to save.
Interest rates really are, talking about interest rates, crazy low right now. I remember back in, I think it was the Jimmy Carter years, the interest rate was 17%. And that's not credit card, that's on a mortgage, 17%. So yeah. I know when I got mine a few years later at 8%. I thought 8% was a fantastic deal. So buyers today, I think they're really spoiled. I mean, anything under 4, 4.5 is fantastic, I think.
Absolutely. And think about all how much more buying power you have if you're below 4% versus a 5 or a 6% interest rate.
So I want to brag a little bit on Wyndham Capital Mortgage, because a friend of mine who is a real estate agent is working with one of your coworkers, Matt Murphy, and bidding wars. And Matt, so they needed an updated pre-approval letter because the price change was different. It was 7 o'clock at night. Matt pulled over the side of the road and from his phone emailed the new pre-approval letter. And I think that's really great customer service.
Yeah, absolutely. Matt's a great guy. And you're right. It's so important when you're choosing your lender and your loan officer, you really want to make sure that you're working with someone who's going to be available. And in our, you know, in our business, nights and evenings and weekends, you know, are just, they're a necessity. And you want to make
not
sure
you're not a job.
Yeah, it's absolutely not a 9-to-5 job. So you want to make sure that your loan officer is going to be available. My office line rings right to my cell phone. So in most cases, I can answer or, you know, at the very least, call you back pretty quickly.
But what is your number?
It is 913-213-0613.
And that really is so nice, Myra, because there are some companies where you get a toll-free number and then you have to press a 4-digit extension and then you get a recording and they say, hey, we'll call you within 24 hours. I mean, I'm sorry, that is just lousy customer service.
It
just
absolutely. And in this market, you can't operate that way.
Well, there's no way you're going to win. If you're working with a buyer and you're in a bidding war, you've got to be able to reach your mortgage loan consultant. Am I saying that right? You're a loan officer, a mortgage loan consultant.
Loan consultant. Yeah, that's right. Yeah,
I like that fancy title. Well, thanks so much for being with us. We really appreciate it. Wyndham Capital Mortgage with Myra McFarland. So, Myra, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate the information you gave us.
Thanks, Tana.
All right, join us next time for another episode of Ask the Expert on Fox 4.